Another trailblazer role is understanding the environment in which the team exists. For lots of teams, this means the external business environment outside the organization's boundaries. But if you're part of a larger company, it can also include the corporate environment in which your team exists. Most companies and even teams eventually fail because they lose their relevance, and this means that they haven't adapted to the changing environment. Sometimes this is inevitable, but on other occasions it's very preventable. So one of your roles as a trailblazer is to pay attention to what's happening outside your team so that you can help the team adapt as necessary. Here are the kinds of questions you should be asking. Who are our most important customers, internal or external? What are their needs? What are their expectations? And how are they changing? How might they be different in the future? How can we adapt and be more responsive to their needs? Who are our other stakeholders? And by that I mean any individual or group, like upper management who has a stake in your success. What do they think about us? How are their expectations changing? What are some of the changes in the external environment that could impact our business or even impact our team? And these could include things like technology and the economy and political, even regulatory climate. How do we need to adapt to these changes? How is the competition changing for our business or for my team? How do we need to gain or maintain our competitive advantage, and so on? Depending on the size of your business, you might think that some of these questions aren't relevant to you or your team, but being a trailblazer means that you have your eyes wide open. Or maybe you're thinking that you're limited in how much you can influence some of these factors because of your position in your organization, and that may be very true sometimes. But you can become a better leader by looking at the landscape ahead, rather than trying to drive forward by looking into the rearview mirror. You'll be more valuable to your team and the organization. You also have to decide how much of this information to share with your team. My bias is a lot. You show respect for people by keeping them informed. More importantly, you can tap into their collective genius as you share what's going on in the environment and let them share some ownership, take some ownership. Even come up with some ways to keep your team relevant and at the top of their game. As I talked about in the last lecture, you can bring information like this to the team meetings and then have open discussions about the meaning of this information, as well as problem-solving discussions about how you might respond as a team. Allowing people to play this role increases their engagement, ownership, and motivation. It's a great way to build a high-performing team.